In July of 2016, the YouTube channel Debug Live posted a video about a guy who was working on cracking the Saturn's bootloader so that a device could theoretically be inserted into the expansion port, where the video CD expansion card traditionally went. This device would hypothetically be the EverDrive of the Sega Saturn, a system that was, and has continued to be, prohibitively expensive to collect for, with numerous games that never got ported away from the platform selling for hundreds of dollars. The man in that video goes by Professor Abrasive, and the device is no longer hypothetical. It's here, and it's called the Satiator. I'm Joe, this is Same Name Different Game Guide N, and I've got me one. To start this off, let me say that I have in no way been compensated for this video. I was not given a unit for review purposes or anything like that. I've backed Professor Abrasive on Patreon for a while, and I purchased this unit myself. With that out of the way, let's get into things. The Satiator, as I said, slots into the back of the Saturn. Not the cart slot where your 4-meg RAM cart goes, but near that watch battery you have to keep replacing so your Saturn doesn't forget what time it is every time you turn it on. This was, as I said, used during the system's life as a home for a video RAM expansion that allowed the Saturn to read video CDs, if you remember those, which also allowed a small handful of games to have better quality FMVs. Because of this, no soldering or taking your system apart is necessary. Just open the hatch and slot it in. There are two parts to the firmware on this device, the actual firmware as well as a separate menu file, both of which are available on satiator.net, and it's of course recommended that should you get one of these, make sure that both are the most up-to-date, as bugs are constantly being squashed. In fact, during the production of this video, games like X-Men vs. Street Fighter went from not working properly to working, though that didn't really matter to me because of another reason that I do like this device. I have a disc copy. Since this solution doesn't require removing your laser assembly like other options for Saturn Flash hardware, I could still play that copy, or any of the other retail games I have, should I feel the need, but to be perfectly honest, I probably won't. The menu system supports subfolders, so you can do as I have here and break your games into sections of the alphabet in order to more easily sort, which is nice, because not all devices for systems like this support that, believe it or not. This device also, as most do, will allow you to play fan-made hacks or mods of games, like this hack of Symphony of the Night that makes use of the 4-meg RAM expansion, as well as translations of games like Linkle Liver Story, which is a ridiculous name, yes, but it's a game from the same folks who made the classic Genesis action RPG Crusader of Senti. Honestly, I have almost no complaints about this device, and any issues I've seen seem to get cleared up immediately. For example, if you use an action replay cart as a RAM cart and memory cart, like I do, you'll need to put a modified firmware on it so it doesn't hijack the Saturn's boot sequence before the Satiator can. But Professor Abrasive and members of the community have made that custom firmware that you can flash to your cart without losing your save games right from the Satiator menu. However, mine wasn't working for some reason. These things are widely bootlegged. I'm sure I ordered mine from Hong Kong. It was well over a decade ago. So I opened it up, sent a picture of the interior to the good professor at his request, and literally within hours, he'd patched the firmware to recognize my action replay, and I was able to put the custom firmware on it. And with that, I can play games that use the 1-meg or 4-meg RAM carts and keep using my save games. In fact, someone has even made a memory management utility so you don't have to take extra steps, like resetting your game to get to the action replay menu to manage the memory. It will even allow you to put save games on the Satiator's memory card if you'd rather do that. Speaking of putting utilities onto this device, it's really nice to be able to just drag and drop games from the redump sets onto a memory card and use them. For example, the Dreamcast optical drive emulator that I personally use, the GDMU, doesn't allow for that, requiring a specific format. But redump images are much more convenient and generally considered to be good quality. So with that, you're off to the races. Compatibility is high, and the Satiator bypasses the region lock on the system, so almost anything you want to play is at your fingertips. Honestly, there are only two complaints that I could see someone having, even if I personally don't share them. First is that you can, of course, no longer use the original video CD expansion card, which isn't really that big of a deal, given the only game that actually requires it to play, Lunar Silver Star Story Complete, has now been hacked to not require it. Second is the price. For me, the plug-and-play nature of the Satiator was worth it. I can't solder, and I don't love opening my systems, though I have done it before. The other two similar devices, Terra Onion's Mode and the Fenrir, are cheaper, though the Mode ships from Europe, so for US buyers that could make quite the difference. On the other hand, the Mode also supports the Dreamcast, but let's be real, I don't think most people are going to be freely swapping an optical disc drive replacement between two separate consoles when doing so requires the systems to be opened up every time. Still, neither of these devices require soldering, so if you don't mind opening your system, it might be worth it to look into them, though beware, the Fenrir is not compatible with every Saturn model. But honestly, that's really it. The system has largely been fuss-free for me, and the issues I did have, as I said, were fixed very quickly with new firmware. This is a great way to save wear and tear on an old CD drive and maybe discover some new games. It took over 4 years to become a reality, but I think the wait was worth it, and if you're a Saturn fan who likes playing on real hardware, I'd recommend considering it. Hey folks, it's Joe. Thanks so much for watching me talk about the Satiator. I recently got an X-Station optical drive emulator for my PS1 as well. Is that something you'd like to hear me talk about? If so, let me know in the comments. And while you're at it, check out the links down below for merch, affiliate links to small businesses, and of course, Patreon and channel memberships. This channel remains ad-free thanks to the cool people you see here, and you can join them for just $1 per video. You'll get early access to new videos and the chance to vote in polls like the one that decided what this very video should be about. If you would rather that I'd talked about the Sega Astro City mini cabinet, you missed your chance, but in the future you might get your way. For more Saturn videos, the video on the left is about a lot of the games in the Saturn library that were left in Japan, while the video on the right is about Virtua Fighter.